start by explaining to you first what range is. When somebody's got good range or bad range, let me explain first what bad range is. Get in your stance, Mike. Say, Mike and myself are fighting. Okay, now, bad range is that I feel like I want to get up. This is my reach right here. This is how far I can reach. I want to get this close before I start punching at him. Okay, see here? That's how close I want to get if I've got bad range. Now, what is causing this is naturally I'm thinking in the sense that my arms are only this long, and I'm watching him, and when he gets close enough that I think I can punch, you know, I'm going to try to hit him with it. But see, this is not where you initiate your punches from. What you do is you get in this position right here as such. Get your hands up. Get your hands up, Mike. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one step out with my right leg and one step out with my left leg. Now, this is where I really want to initiate my punches from. This is the range in which I want to box. Now, the reason for this is because get in your stance again, Mike. Okay? Now, you say, well, you can't reach him from here. Well, I can. As a matter of fact, without moving my right foot, and that's my push foot, without moving my right foot, I can actually punch through him to the other side of his head. I can hit him with a right uppercut from this range right here, or a left uppercut from this range right here. I don't have to get up to here before I punch. And the reason I don't is because by doing this here, I mean, all I have to do is step to make contact. Now, if he and I are boxing, and we're both in our rhythm boxing, and he's going to try to get this close to me before he punches each time, he's going to be in deep trouble. He's going to be in deep trouble because I'm going to initiate everything I do from out here. And that's why you see little short guys able to jab tall guys, and you say, how in the world are they able to do this? They don't have as much reach as the other guy. Well, that's how, because they know exactly where to initiate their punches from in order to get them a maximum amount of distance and range between them and the other guy. And this also has to do with your power. If I'm this close, if I have to jab or throw my punches from this close, a lot of times I'm going to smother my punches because more than likely he's making an advancement too when I punch. So therefore I'm smothering a lot of things. Okay. Whereas from out here, when I initiate my punches, you know, I'm going to get maximum leverage because I'm going to hit him on the end of everything.
Okay, so I'm trying to aim the jab so that it goes at his neck or his chest so that when he drops down to shoot me, he'll drop into it instead of punching it where he was and ended up missing. And then once I make contact here and can find him, it's kind of stopping his forward momentum, but it also allows me to try to find his chin with the next punch. So a lot of times if he's throwing wild punches and there's a lot of, you know, really scrambling, I can't tell what's going on so much, but I can feel when I make that contact and bring the next punch in. I'm trying to throw the jab so that it's aimed at his chest, so that when he drops down, he goes into it. I'm trying to get his, if I punch up here where his chin is and he drops down, I don't hit it. So I gotta aim where his chin's gonna go when he drops down. So I wanna snap it like right there and try to get his chin to drop down to it. Changes from, critical distance changes from full arm to half arm too fast. I gotta try to meet him with the hook. And I want to go away from his wild swiping right hand on the angle and throw the hook. I'm making him miss, making him try to keep coming forward because he keeps exposing his chin. Okay, now, another thing is that when he goes under this, he's susceptible to the uppercut. So I got to turn the next punch under. I throw the half arm punch, he goes under it, I got to come back with the uppercuts, the body and the head. So try and turn him back. Turn him up. It's going to take me all the way back. I got to go on the angles, and then I got to change direction. basic footwork. Let's skip out, pivot off of him. You gotta pivot off of his pressure. You can't just dance around in front of him. That's all his pressure. You gotta react with your core. Now, I gotta go to a closer gap and meet him with the hook coming in. And I wanna break ground to the angle, not go straight backwards. If I punch up and move out, I gotta go with the hook. I go out, and he keeps coming, then I'm gonna spin him, or I'm gonna spin out to the angle and get away. Now what this does is it keeps him from being able to look at me the whole time he's coming forward trying to shoot me. He's gonna have to go underneath that hook. Can't just keep getting hit with it. So he goes underneath it, he can't see in that instant.